Hello, today we have a very bad case again. You can see this Lagotto Romagnolo is in a pretty bad shape and he is very, very matted and neglected. He was found by a woman in a place near my city and brought him to me for a groom. He seems to be a very, very, very nice dog, so hopefully I won't have troubles with grooming him. Okay. But before I start, I just want to say a few words about this guy. He's been living in my salon. Today is Sunday. He's been living here since Wednesday, since he was groomed. And he's doing great. He's eating well, he's drinking. He's letting me pet him. He's actually allowing anyone to pet him. Yesterday there were two little kids playing with him. So he's a great dog. He allowed me to lift him up. And he's great with other dogs. He's healthy, he does not have heartworm. We just need to get him neutered in next Wednesday and finish his ear treatment. He's going to need 3 more ear treatments once a week. And we already found a home for him after all of that is finished. So he's going to be one great dog. And one thing, he's walking next to my legs when he's on the leash. He's sleeping here. On the day I'm with him, I take him out for walks. I always come early and finish later because of him, but he's a great dog. And I actually wanted to give him a bath today because I realized that he is super relaxed now, I can lift him up. But this guy showed up, it was an emergency. So I'm going to bathe him next time and make it all nice and even. You know, some hair is sticking out. And I'm going to film it, I'm going to film him in a walk so you can see how he's doing. Okay. So let's go back to this dog. I think that he'll be able to find a good home pretty quickly because he's a Lagotto Romagnolo. Okay, just going to let him sniff the clipper, pet him, touch him with the clipper. And actually I'm going to do his head first. I'm going to start with these big mats. Okay, I'm going to start with the top of his head. I might have to shut it down. He's not sedated. Okay, I'll just start from his body. Hopefully he'll be fine for that. This is a 10 blade that I use. He's not sedated because he seemed so relaxed and hopefully we'll be able to groom him without any sedation, because it's evening, as you can see, it's a quarter to 9 p.m. and it's also Sunday, so it's very hard to find a veterinarian. That works now. Okay, you just need to stop and do this with the hair so the clipper can go under. Don't worry, I'm checking if the blade is too warm. It is not. Blade is not that warm, but I'm going to change it. Take the next stand blade. Spray this one with a spray that cools it. Okay. Yeah, the woman that found him named him Lucky. Okay, let's take the scissors. And no, you cannot take the mats off with scissors. You can just make the room for the clipper. You have to use a clipper for those mats. Okay. Pa nemam pojma. Mislim da je onako bolje drugačije, ono. Change the blade again. Actually, I'm going to take the shorter blade for this steel. I'm going to take the 15 one. And oil it. You have to be very careful when you're grooming the tail. You don't want to hurt the tip of the tail. Okay, so that was not pleasant. Okay, then blade back again. And there are threads, like at this case you can use the scissors, but when it's all coming out in one piece, the scissors will not help, so Okay, let's try the keeper. This ear is totally matted and the mats are tied up with the mats from under the ear, so this is probably very, very unpleasant for him. Hopefully he'll realize that he's feeling better and better and he'll just stop moving, but this is totally understandable. This is probably the first time he's being groomed. He does not know us. Okay, I'm going to let him chill. I mean, let his head chill from the clipper. I'm going to take the shorter blade. Blade again. Okay, so this did great for the front leg. That's a good sign. Normally dogs hate when the clipper is touching their front legs, especially when it is a case like that, when dog is not used to anything that we are doing right now. So it looks like the head is the only problem, but it's good that he's not reacting aggressively when we touch his head, when we try to groom his head. He just is moving. Okay, you have to be careful. This dog is not neutered, so I have to be very careful around his private area.
Thank you.
Okay, so he is pretty relaxed now. I like that very much. See, he's not reacting. Switch the blades. And yeah, he's going to be a great dog. I think that he's going to find a new home pretty soon. Okay, 15 blade again. Okay, let's do his private area. Okay. Okay, let's take a break for a minute. He deserves it. I am not concerned about this front leg. I'm only concerned about the head. But you're going to do it a little bit with scissors, a little bit with clipper, but you're doing it. Okay, so we took a 5 minute break and let's proceed now. And a climber. Thank you. Okay, I'll try to do this area with scissors, little by little. And the mats are very close to the skin, which makes it even more difficult. Okay, let's try to do more with the clipper. It's easier and less risky. Okay, I'll just have to finish his head with scissors. It's not going to look as clean and it would be with clipper, but he's just moving too much. I don't want to risk hurting him. Okay, so I made a decision to do as much as I can with scissors around the head and the neck. It's just too stressful for him to try to use a clipper, you saw it. And then when he comes for the next groom, his head is going to be scissored there anyway. I mean the hair on his head. So if he's that afraid of the clipper, you heard it's not a loud clipper, but he's just terrified when it's around his head. Again, it's much bigger risk to do this with scissors. But I'm just going to do as much as I can. Okay, so this is enough. If I'll have to leave something, it's better to do that than to injure the dog. So as you can see, it's not ideal, but it is probably his first groom. The most important thing is take the mats off. Which I need. I'll just try to do this area under the armpit. Okay, just going to change my gloves and pluck the hair from his ears. Okay, as you can see, this is a big piece of matted hair in his ears. So this is going to be unpleasant for him. So I'm going to put a muzzle on. This is an old school muzzle, you just take the bandage. Tie it on the top of the nose, the bottom, and then behind the head. Okay. So this here needs to be plucked out. Okay, that was easy. That was very easy. This is the ear powder that makes this hair less slippery and easier to be plucked out. And you have to pluck this hair from dog's ears, because when there's no hair in the ear, the air can flow through the ear, and the chances of an ear getting infected are lower. I'm going to take the hemostat. You can see there's a lot here. Okay. This is a cotton wool. I'm going to use it to clean the ears. are going to look much, much better than before. So I left the muzzle on because this can be unpleasant. I do not know how he will react till the end, and I'm also going to leave it for the nail clipping. Then I'm going to take it off. This is a great dog. He's just terrified of clipper being near his head. That can change. I had dogs that had been terrified from the clipper being near their head, and then after a while they got okay with that. That his ears are looking much better. The veterinarian is going to have to check them. But I think that they look very good now. I'm going to clip his nails, hopefully he'll be fine for that. I don't need to cut too much. Yeah, he's been great. Okay, let's take this off, and we're going to take a 5-minute break, let him chill out, clean the table, clean the blades, and get him to the bathtub. Okay, Sanja is going to give him a bath now. Okay, so we gave him a bath. It wasn't easy. And we dried him. He was okay for the blow dryer. And now all I have to do is shave his body again. Like that. And now I finished the second shave of his body. Just going to scissor. Okay. Around the head a little more. Try to make it as clean as I can. Okay, this is it. He's done. The most important thing is that the mats are off, the ears are clean, and he's washed, and hopefully he's going to find a new home very soon. Thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you for supporting this channel. We were not talking too much in this video because, as you can see, if you can see, it is almost midnight and we are working tomorrow, so we are very tired. And this is it. I'm going to let him down now. Okay, let's put him on the floor. The reason why I took the leash is because they're both males. I know that the black one is great with other dogs and males, but I don't know about this guy. So you should always be careful. And this is a good dog. He was scared. He had reasons to be scared. Okay, we're going to take a walk. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we will definitely see you soon. Bye.